The Mary Tyler Moore Show was a hugely influential, not to mention ridiculously popular, sitcom created by James L. Brooks and Allan Burns, starring Mary Tyler Moore. The lighthearted and witty show aired on CBS from September 19, 1970 to March 19, 1977. Moore portrayed Mary Richards, an unmarried, fiercely independent woman who was focused on her career as an associate producer of the fictional WJM news program in Minneapolis. A leading female character who was neither married nor dependent on a man was a rarity on American television in the 70s. As such, many publications declared The Mary Tyler Moore Show to be a groundbreaking series. While The Mary Tyler Moore Show is without a doubt one of the most important sitcoms to ever hit the small screen, unfortunately almost every major cast member and the majority of its supporting cast are no longer alive. In this video, we're going to tell you how each member of its cast passed away. Mary Tyler Moore, Mary Richards. Without a doubt, nobody besides Mary Tyler Moore could have embodied the role of Mary Richards like she did. Before signing on to the series that shared her name, she had a recurring role as Laura Petrie in The Dick Van Dyke Show from 1961 to 66. Throughout her career, she won 7 Emmy Awards and 3 Golden Globes. In addition to being an accomplished actress, Moore was an outspoken advocate for animal rights, vegetarianism, and diabetes prevention. She was a recovering alcoholic who was diagnosed with type 1 diabetes in 1969 after a miscarriage. In 2011, she had surgery to remove a benign brain tumor called a meningioma. In 2014, it's reported she had heart and kidney problems, in addition to being almost entirely blind due to complications of her diabetes. Moore passed away from cardiopulmonary arrest, complicated by pneumonia, on January 25, 2017, at Greenwich Hospital in Greenwich, Connecticut. She was 80. Hey, if you're enjoying this video so far, make sure you give it a like and subscribe to Factsverse if you haven't already. And stick around to see which actors and actresses from The Mary Tyler Moore Show have died and which ones are still alive. Gavin Macleod, Murray Slaughter. Macleod is perhaps best known for playing Merrill Steubing, the ship's captain, on The Love Boat. On The Mary Tyler Moore Show, he portrayed Murray Slaughter, Mary's closest co-worker and friend. After appearing in 168 episodes of The Mary Tyler Moore Show, Macleod continued to work in TV until a decade before his death, appearing in shows like Murder, She Wrote, Oz, JAG, That 70s Show, and most recently in 2011's animated children's series Pound Puppies. Macleod died in his home in Palm Desert, California on May 29, 2021, at the age of 90, after a brief period of battling undisclosed health issues. Ted Knight, Ted Baxter. While he was best known for his role on The Mary Tyler Moore Show, Knight also appeared in the sitcom Too Close for Comfort as Henry Rush. You might also remember him as Judge Elihu Smales in Caddyshack. Sadly, just a few months after The Mary Tyler Moore Show wrapped up in 1977, Knight was diagnosed with colon cancer. After receiving various treatments, his cancer briefly went into remission, but in 1985 it returned with a vengeance. Despite undergoing vigorous treatments, it spread throughout his bladder and gastrointestinal tract. His condition declined, but he kept working, despite his doctor's recommendation to take it easy. He died August 26, 1986, at age 62. Valerie Harper, Rhoda Morgenstern. While Harper was best known for her role as Rhoda Morgenstern on The Mary Tyler Moore Show and its spinoff series Rhoda, she's also remembered for appearing in shows like Chapter 2 and Valerie, which ran from 1986 to 87. She later returned to her first love, theater, appearing in several Broadway productions. In 2010, she was honored with a Tony Award for Best Actress in a Play for her performance as Tallulah Bankhead in the stage play Looped. In 2009, she was diagnosed with lung cancer, and in 2013, she revealed she also had leptomeningeal carcinomatosis, a rare disorder where cancerous cells spread into the membranes surrounding the brain. She further revealed her doctors had given her as little as 3 months to live, but she defied medical expectations and lived while receiving regular chemotherapy treatments to slow the spread of her cancer. But by 2019, she was on a regimen of various medications and drugs and reportedly experiencing a great deal of physical pain. She passed away on the morning of August 30th, 2019, at age 80. Cloris Leachman, Phyllis Lindstrom. Leachman's career as an actress and comedian spanned more than 7 decades. Throughout that time, she won many accolades, including 8 Primetime Emmy Awards. With 22 nominations, she was tied with Julia Louis-Dreyfus for being the most nominated and awarded actress. In addition to having a thriving career in TV, she was also a highly sought-after film star. She was a part of Mel Brooks's ensemble cast and appeared in films like Young Frankenstein and History of the World Part 1. Some of her later credits include roles in shows and films like Malcolm in the Middle, Spanglish, Mrs. Harris, and Raising Hope. Leachman died in her sleep in Encinitas, California on January 27, 2021. She was 94 years old. The cause of death was determined to be the result of a stroke with COVID-19 as a contributing factor. Nancy Walker, Ida Morgenstern. Walker is best remembered for her role as Mildred on McMillan and Wife and Ida Morgenstern on The Mary Tyler Moore Show. She later reprised that role and became a prominent recurring character on the spin-off series Rhoda. Walker was a lifelong heavy smoker. At age 69, she died of lung cancer in Studio City, California on March 25, 1992. Georgia Engel, Georgette Franklin Baxter. After playing Georgette Baxter on The Mary Tyler Moore Show, Engel continued to act for several decades. She notably portrayed Pat McDougal on Everybody Loves Raymond from 2003 to 2005. Throughout her career, she received a total of 5 Primetime Emmy Award nominations. She died April 12, 2019, at the age of 70 in Princeton, New Jersey. The cause of death was unknown. Now let's take a brief moment to recognize the stars of the show that are still alive and well. Betty White, Sue Ann Nivens. White is regarded as a pioneer of television. Her career in the industry spans over 90 years, and she was one of the first women to take the reins of control in front of and behind the camera. She's also the first woman to produce a sitcom, Life with Elizabeth. White has worked longer on TV than anyone else in history and was awarded the Guinness World Record for that feat in 2018. She's received 8 Emmy Awards in various categories, 3 American Comedy Awards, 3 Screen Actors Guild Awards, and a Grammy for her countless contributions to the realm of entertainment. Betty is 99 years old and still appears to be in reasonably good health. Hopefully, she'll continue to stick around for a while. Ed Asner, Lou Grant. Asner has had a prolific career as an actor, voice artist, and the former president of the Screen Actors Guild. He's one of the last surviving regular cast members of both The Mary Tyler Moore Show and its spin-off series, Lou Grant. He's the most honored male performer in the history of the Primetime Emmy Awards, having won 7. Asner continued to remain active after The Mary Tyler Moore Show and Lou Grant. Most recently, he appeared in the 6th season of The Good Wife and in a 2020 episode of Modern Family. He has a recurring role as James Staghorn Sr. on Briar Patch. Now it's time to hear from you. In the comments section below, let us know which trailblazing sitcom you liked the most, The Mary Tyler Moore Show or The Dick Van Dyke Show. And before you go, make sure you give this video a like and subscribe to Facts First if you haven't already. Click the bell icon to stay updated on all our latest content.